Welcome students, I am Nafisa, your social science teacher. We are discussing agriculture topic, in that major crops in India. Last video we have covered major food crops. They are rice, wheat, millets, maize and pulses. Today's session we will cover the topic food crops other than grains. These are food crops which we use, but they are not the grain shape. As I have said you before, we will discuss this through a tabular form so that it's easy for you to understand, to learn and to remember. As I have said, previous session we have covered the topics rice, wheat, millets, maize and pulses. Today we will cover the topic sugarcane, oil seeds, tea, coffee and horticulture, which comes under the subheading food crops other than grains. So first one, sugarcane. Sugarcane is a kharif crop and the temperature required for it is in between 21 to 27 degrees Celsius and rainfall 75 to 100 centimeter. Whereas soil, it need well drained alluvial soil, and other variety of soils also can be used with proper irrigation facility. India is the second largest producer, whereas first place goes to Brazil, and India is second largest producer in sugarcane. And it is a tropical and subtropical crop. To understand this, let me show you India map. So tropical region, in the sense the areas which are near the equator. So as you can see, Tropic of Cancer crosses through India, through Gujarat. So this area, the area below the Tropic of Cancer, which is near to equator, comes under the tropical region, and the area about Tropic of Cancer is referred to as subtropical region. So this is a special feature of India which allows different variety of crops, because the climatic conditions are different, soil type is different. So variety of crops can be from both tropical type and subtropical types of crops can be grown in India. And the location: Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. These are the states where sugarcane can be grown. Along with this, sugarcane can be found in different varieties also. As you can see in the picture, it can be found in the form of sugar, in the form of molasses, in the form of gud, in the form of khandsari. The major sugar producing states are Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana and Punjab. Next important crop is oil seeds. Daily you might have seen in your kitchen while preparing food, every time oil is been used, and oil can be extracted from different types of seeds. So these are the major oil seed crops grown in India. Groundnut, every one of us know, majority of our homes we use either groundnut oil or sunflower oil. Along with that, we can find oil with safflower, soya bean, linseed, mustard seeds, castor oil, sesame oil, niger. So these are the different seeds from which oil can be extracted. Among oil seeds, very important oil seed is groundnut. It can be grown in the kharif season, like monsoon season, so it is referred to as kharif crop. It needs temperature from 20 to 30 degrees Celsius, rainfall from 50 to 75 centimeters, and it can be grown in red soil. And India is the second largest producer of groundnut in the world after China. China is the first groundnut producer, whereas India takes the second position. And oil seeds grown in India covers total 12% of the cropped area. In India, whatever cropping is done, in the 12% cropping is of oil seeds only. Whereas Gujarat is the largest producer of groundnut, followed by Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Then let's have a look at other oil seeds like linseeds, mustard. These two comes under rabi crops. And India is the third producer in mustard seeds, whereas Canada takes the first position and China second position. Oil seeds are majorly used for cooking purpose. also used for the production of soap, cosmetics and ointments. And another type is sesame one, okay, sesame seeds, till we say it as till. So kharif crop, even it is a kharif crop in north and rabi crop in south. When it comes to castor seeds, we in Telugu we call it as amudamo, nuna, which has been used for hair, for cooking purpose it's used very less. Both it is grown as rabi and kharif crop. These are all about oil seeds. And let's go for the next one, tea, very important beverage crop of India. So for it and very important for you in the when it comes to board examination also, beverage crops, tea or coffee has been covered in majority of the questions. So temperature required 21 degrees to 29 degrees Celsius, and rainfall you can check here 150 centimeters to 250 centimeters, highest rainfall among all the crops. Frequent showers are required. It need frequent showers distributed throughout the area. And soil is mountain soil, deep and fertile, well-drained soil, rich in humus and organic matter. So it requires special type of soil. That's what whenever you see tea plantation, you can find it in hilly areas. Tea is a plantation crop and it's a beverage crop. India is the leading producer of tea in the world and grows well in tropical and subtropical climate. As I have just shown you India map, India is has a tropical and subtropical climate, which makes a special distinctive feature for the tree growing area. And one more important point of tea is tea is a labor intensive industry. It requires abundant, cheap and skilled labor. Tea is processed within the tea garden to restore its freshness. I'll show you tea garden, picture of a tree garden. As you can see in the picture, lot of labor force is required because they need to tear the tender leaves. It should not be ripened up. So a lot of labor intensive. So this is the picture of a tea plantation. Most probably in hilly areas, it is grown. So major tea producing areas are Assam, and in West Bengal the areas of Darjeeling along with Meghalaya and Tripura, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, and in southern states Tamil Nadu, Kerala, and in Andhra Pradesh we have Arku Valley region, hilly region. So in that area we can find the tea production. And India is the leading producer as well as exporter of tea in the world. Let's have another important beverage crop after tea. It is coffee. Even it requires 15 degree to 28 degree Celsius of temperature and rainfall from 150 centimeter to 250 centimeters of rainfall, most similar rainfall. Frequent showers distributed throughout the year. And that's what even coffee has also been grown in the hilly regions. Hill slopes are most suitable for the growth of this crop. Whereas coffee plant is coffee is also a plantation crop and a beverage crop. Indian coffee is known for its quality throughout the world. Whereas India coffee is been brought from Arabica variety from Yemen. Okay, into coffee breed has been brought into India through Yemen and it is referred to as Arabica variety. And India produces 3.2 of the total world coffee production. Coffee was initially introduced on the Baba Budem hills of Karnataka and later on it's been spread around the areas, Nilgiri areas of Karnataka, okay? Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu region. Coffee seeds look something like this. Later on these are dried off and made into a powder and made into coffee bean. Now let's have a look at the horticulture crop. Horticulture in the sense relating to fruits and vegetables. And India's position is the second position, okay? Second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in India, in the world after China. So China is the takes first position in horticulture, whereas India takes second position. So India can produce tropical as well as temperate fruits. As I have shown you through India map, India lies in tropical and subtropical region. So both varieties of crops can be grown in India. Like if you see mangoes of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal are very famous. When it comes to oranges, Nagpur and Chirapunji region in Meghalaya are very famous. Then bananas of Kerala, Mizoram, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. When it comes to lychee and guava of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. When it comes to pineapples, Meghalaya and grapes of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra region. Apple and pears, apricot and walnuts of Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh are in great demand all over the world. Even you can check in your textbook pictures given in the textbook. So have a look at the picture here. Apricots, apple, pomegranate, cultivation of vegetables, peas, cauliflower, tomato and brinjal. So these are all famous crops of India. As you can see here, India is the important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomato, brinjal and potato. So with this we have covered food crops without grains. Now our next topic is non-food crops. Means we are growing the crops, but it's not for the purpose of as a source of food, but it has been used for the other purposes. So those are rubber and then fiber crops we'll discuss now. So now under non-food crops, let's cover rubber. Rubber is a equatorial crop, but under special conditions it can also grown in tropical and subtropical areas. Let me show you. As I have shown you before, India lies in tropical and subtropical region because India is near the equator and Tropic of Cancer is crossing through India. So especially southern part of India lies in subtropical region, whereas northern part of India lies in subtropical region. It requires moist and humid climate with rainfall about more than 200 centimeters. And temperature above 25 degrees Celsius. And rubber is an important industrial raw material. And it is grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, as you can see, southern states, Andaman, Nicobar. Here comes list the items that are made of rubber and used by us. Like you can say these points during the time of discussion. Like rubber can be used for making boots, raincoats, pond liners, mattresses, cushions, grips on garden tools, bathtubs, plugs, doorstops, ear plugs, bottles, aquarium tubing, everywhere, many places we use rubber. So next non-food crop is fiber crop. In fiber crop, we will cover cotton and jute for today's class. Along with that, we have hemp and natural silk also. But today's lesson, we are covering cotton and jute as the major one, and sericulture, silk rearing. Okay, the first three are derived from crops and grown in the soil. Okay, cotton, jute and hemp are derived from crops from the soil. Whereas when it comes to natural silk, it is obtained from cocoons of the silkworms fed on green leaves, especially mulberry leaves. Rearing of silkworms for the production is referred to as sericulture. Let's have it. So this is silkworm on mulberry leaf. Silkworms are reared on mulberry leaves and they'll form the cocoons, and from that silk is been extracted. Okay, from that silk is been extracted and dyed into different colors. And as you all know, silk sarees, silk dhotis, you all might be wearing during the time of festival seasons or celebrations and marriages. And next comes cotton. Cotton is believed to be the original home cotton plant. Okay, cotton is one of the main raw materials for cotton textile industry. In 2015, India was the second largest producer. First position goes to China, and India is the second largest producer of cotton. And cotton, as we all know, black cotton soil, we call it as black soil cotton can be grown. That's what it got its name also, black cotton soil in the Deccan Plateau region. And it requires high temperature and light rainfall of and it needs, remember this point, 210 frost free days and bright sunshine. And even it is a Kharif crop requires 6 to 8 months to mature. Whereas major cotton producing areas are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, all these are Deccan Plateau region. Where black soil is found, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Whereas few places it can be grown with the help of irrigation. And comes the next topic, jute. Jute is also known as golden fiber. It might be asked for one mark question, what is golden fiber? What is referred to as golden fiber? So you have to write it as jute. Jute is grows well on well-drained, fertile soil. A lot of water is required for the processing of jute and it needs fertile soil. So it's been grown near the flood plain, especially near the flood plains, and it needs high temperature during the time of its growth. Special areas of jute producing areas are West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Orissa and Meghalaya are the major jute producing states. And it's used for making gunny bags, mats, ropes, yarn, carpets and other artifacts. As you know very well, eco-friendly product. In order to avoid plastic, many are encouraging, nowadays people are using jute as a source of eco-friendly product. Due to its high cost, it's losing market to synthetic fibers, but we should avoid the synthetic fibers and we have to shift towards the usage of jute because it is eco-friendly. Okay, let's have a look at jute product. It's one of the picture which shows how jute is been dried off. The processing of jute is going on. So here's a picture which clearly shows the water requirement for jute processing. And even here this is a picture and it has been used in making gunny bags, mats, ropes, yarn and carpet. So students, till now we have covered major crops of India. In that, first we have covered the grains. The crops which are grains like rice, wheat, millets, maize and pulses. And in food crops other than grains, we have covered the crops like sugarcane, oil seeds, tea, coffee, horticulture crops. In non-food crops, we have covered rubber, and under fiber crops, we have covered the topics cotton and jute along with sericulture. Hope you have understood the major crops of India. Still, if you have any doubts, you can message me. Thank you.